Hey everyone, this is TD3425 with the 501st Legion. Today's video is about guns. I'm no stranger to guns when it comes to Star Wars costuming. I've got the Tusken rifle for my Tusken right there. That's from Nick. And the MG15 right there from Michael. But today's video is about the T-21 from Anthony. And just got this yesterday. And this is a piece of art when it comes to prop replica gun. I can't say enough about how impressed I am at the quality of this particular prop. It is an amazing, amazing gun, and very glad I went with it. Let me turn it around here real quick for you just so you can see the other side. We've got all the greeblies, got the straps, barrel fins, and yeah, this is a really, really nice gun. But today's video is also about the upgrade I did to this gun yesterday. Just got it and went ahead and did an upgrade already. What I wanted to do was I wanted to put in some sort of light and sounds into it, and I pulled out a Hasbro E-11 that I had when I first joined the Legion, and ripped the guts out of it. Which is basically just a little soundboard and a trigger and a speaker and an LED light. And so the first thing I had to do was figure out how I was going to put a button in. So I went ahead and hot glued. You can see the yellow button I've got hot glued in there. I've still got to paint the glue black because I glued that last night. But what I did was I cut a channel up the top. And of course, whenever you're trooping with this, you can't see it, so it's not an issue. And the channel itself then goes right there, and you might be able to see it right up the center. Then I drilled a hole straight through the spring, the replica spring there. And again, the channel then goes all the way up there, and it goes to the end of the barrel. And that is for the two wires that come off the push button. And let me show you what it looks like when I pull the barrel off here. Okay, I've got the barrel off, and this is where the barrel slides down over this block of wood. And there's two screws that go through the barrel into the bottom of this piece that hold the barrel to the stock. What I went ahead and did, I'll show you here, is I added a piece of red oak, piece of hardwood right here. And that's just screwed into the stock there, and then on the other side where we got some room is the guts for the E11 components. And so these, you can see the black wires here, that comes up from the channel that comes out of the bottom of the gun. And on this side, you can see it actually here, it goes underneath this piece, and then it comes back out, and then it comes out this side. And then I just wrapped it around to the other side here. And those two wires are soldered onto, see if I can focus it here for you a little bit. There we go. They're just soldered right onto there. That's where the typical push button is for the E11 blaster. So those are just soldered on right there. It's two AA batteries, and there's another little board there, and then that's the default speaker, and then it goes up to the red LED that I put into, you know, the flashlight. And that flashlight tip is what helps reflect it right down to the barrel. So it's a very, very simple setup, and it's very effective. The speaker is loud when the barrel's off. It's not very loud when the barrel is on. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take those two yellow wires that go for the positive and negative on the speaker, and maybe wire those up to like a 1/8 jack, and turn it into more like a line input, and maybe run that into a Radio Shack amp and decase the amp, and maybe put the amp components on the other side over here. And then that way I can adjust the volume of it and have it much, much louder. But this works very, very nice. Again, like I said, it's just one little push button, and when I push it, you know, I get the sound, and then we get the light lit up there. And when you look at it straight on, you know, it's very prominent. It's very bright. So it's a very, very simple hack. And, you know, that's just a standard E-11 blaster from Toys R Us. So the guts just ripped out. And the hardest part, again, is, you know, cutting that channel. And I really, really, you know, didn't want to do it to such a nice gun. But it's on the bottom. And, you know, what I did after I ran the wires in there, every you know, say inch and a half, I put a little bit of hot glue in the bottom of the channel and pushed the wire down in there just to hold it down. And then filled in the whole groove with wood putty. Once the wood putty dried, I sanded it down and then put some primer on this and then just put some black paint on it.